This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about graphing logarithmic functions. So here's the first example. I've got y equals the log base 2 of x. I want to graph this. The first step that I'm going to use will be to convert this to its exponential form. That's going to be 2 raised to the y power equals x. And to make it easier to graph, what I'm going to do is make a table of values. Instead of starting out with x values and figuring out what the y values would be, I'm going to start out with y values and figure out what the x's would be. So let's start out with y equals 0. When y is 0, x is going to be equal to 2 to the 0 power, and any number to the 0 power is just 1. So I'm going to have a point at 1, 0. When y is 1, x is going to equal 2 to the first power. 2 to the first power is 2, so I'll have a point at 2, 1. And when y is 2, x will equal 2 to the second power, or 2 squared. That's 4. Let's put some negative numbers in. When y is negative 1, x is going to equal 2 to the negative 1. So 2 to the negative 1 can be converted into the fraction 1/2. And when y is negative 2, x is going to equal 2 to the negative 2. We'll convert that into a fraction. That would be 1 over 2 squared, or 1 over 4. Okay, let's take these points and sketch in the graph and see what kind of characteristics it has. So I've got a point at 1/4, negative 2, then 1/2, negative 1, 1, 0, that's right on the x-axis, 2, 1, and 4, 2. Let's connect those points. And if I continue the curve that I'm drawing, I see that it continues to curve upward, but not as quickly as it goes on as x gets bigger and bigger. As x gets smaller, the curve is going to approach the y-axis, but it's never going to reach it. Okay, so we're going to have a vertical asymptote at the y-axis, at x equals 0. So let's look at the general characteristics we have here. Obviously, this is an increasing function. You're going to have an increasing function for a logarithm whenever the base of the logarithm is a number greater than 1. The domain looks like the domain is going from 0, not including the 0, up to infinity. So the domain would be all positive numbers. For the range, this graph keeps going down right next to that vertical asymptote, and it keeps increasing upward as x gets bigger. So the range is going to be from negative infinity to positive infinity, or all real numbers. And we have an x-intercept at x equals 1. Now, all of those characteristics, the domain, the range, the vertical asymptote, the x-intercept, would be true for any basic logarithmic function. In other words, a logarithmic function which hasn't gone through any major transformations. Okay? As far as it being an increasing function, that would be true of any logarithmic function where the base is a number bigger than 1. Okay? Let's try another one where the base is a number between 0 and 1. So let's do the log base 1/2 of x equals y. I'll convert that into its exponential form. That would be 1/2 to the y equals x. And once again, I'll make a table of values to help me plot some points. So let's see what happens when y is 0. Well, when y is 0, I'm going to have x equals 1/2 to the 0 power, and that's going to be a 1. So once again, I'm going to have a point at 1, 0. When x is a 1, I have x, when y is 1, I have x equals 1/2 to the first power, which is 1/2. And when x is 2, I've got, when y is 2, I've got x equals 1/2 to the second power. So 1/2 to the second power is the same as 1 squared over 2 squared, which is the same as 1 over 4. So that'll be at 1/4. Let's do some negative numbers. When y is negative 1, I've got 1/2 to the negative 1. If I've got a fraction raised to a negative power, I can invert the fraction and make the power positive. So that's just going to be 2 to the first power, 2 over 1 to the first power, which is 2. And when y is negative 2, I'm going to have 1/2 to the negative 2. I invert that fraction, that 1/2, make it a 2 over 1, and change the sign. So that's 2 over 1 squared, which is 4. Okay, let's plot these points. I've got 4, negative 2. So here's 4 and negative 2. 2, negative 1, that's here. 1, 0. I've already put that in on the x-axis. 1/2, 1 would be here, and 1/4, 2 would be here. I'll connect those points. I've got a curve. It also has a vertical asymptote, just like the last graph we did, has a vertical asymptote at x equals 0, or right along the y-axis. It curves downward, it's decreasing. It gets more and more negative as x increases. The domain and range, just as we saw for the other function, are going to be, the domain will be from 0 to infinity, or all positive numbers, and the range, since it goes up to positive infinity and down to negative infinity, the range will be all real numbers. And I'm going to have an x-intercept at x equals 0, or 1, 0. Okay? So for a function where the, for a logarithmic function, where the base is a number between 0 and 1, you're going to have a decreasing function. Its other characteristics are going to be the same as the characteristics you saw for the first function we did, the log base 2, or any function, no matter what the base is going to be, as long as there's no major transformations. So in general, we can say about logarithmic functions that have not gone through transformations, their domain is going to be positive numbers from 0 to infinity. Their range is going to be all real numbers. They'll have a vertical asymptote along the y-axis at x equals 0. And they'll have an x-intercept at x equals 1, okay, or 1, 0. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.